55:22.
Cast your cares on the Lord, and he will sustain you. He will sustain you.
Good morning and welcome to Prayer and Devotion on this Saturday. Today is Saturday, October 21st. That was Cast Your Cares from Psalm 55:22, and that was the Seeds Family Worship. Never heard of them, but it went perfectly with today's scripture, and it was kind of a catchy little tune that'll probably be stuck in my head today, which is always a good thing. So I hope you enjoyed that. That was Cast Your Cares from Seeds Family Worship. Today we are looking at Psalm 55:22, and we're going to be talking about what to do with burdens, But let me say good morning to all of you on this Saturday. Good morning, Barbara. It's good to have you here praying for you this morning. And Jerry, I'm glad you're with us, holding you in prayer today. Good morning, Lisa. It's good to have you here praying for you this morning. And Susan, I'm glad you're with us as well, holding you in prayer today. Good morning, Daniel. Glad you're with us, praying for you this morning. And Sue, I'm glad you're here too, praying for you today. Good morning, Gloria. I'm glad you're with us. Got to see Wesley last night, praying for you today. And Marilyn, I'm glad you're with us as well, holding you in prayer as we start the day. So good to be with you today. We're looking at Psalm 55:22. I invite you to open up your Bibles to that place. And as you're doing that, my name is Cindy Stauffer. I'm blessed to serve as a pastor at the United Methodist Church at New Brunswick. Our church building is going through some construction right now. So we are on the corner of George and Liberty Street, right in the heart of the city of New Brunswick. Our building is And we're getting a little bit of a front makeover. So you can't miss a scaffolding if you're looking for our church. But it's good to have you here today. I'm glad you found us. It's good to start our day in God's word and praying with and for one another. So let's jump into Psalm 55, verse 22. You already knew it because you just heard it. Cast your burdens on the Lord, and he will sustain you. He will never permit the righteous to be moved or the righteous to fall. Cast your cares on the Lord, and he will sustain you, and he will never, ever let the righteous fall. Today's devotion is entitled, What to Do with Burdens, and it comes from Joyce Meyer's Strength for Each Day. She writes, the Israelites were commanded to keep one day each week, the seventh day, as a day of complete rest. And on that day, they could do no work, nor carry any burdens in or out of their homes. This rest was a type and shadow of the true rest that God offers us today. The true rest of God is not offered to one race of people for one day a week, but it is offered to all of those who are called by God, and it is available for every moment of every day. Sabbath rest includes the absence of burden bearing. Just as we are invited to cast our sin on the Lord, we are also invited to cast our cares on him. Let me encourage you to shut the door to all the burdensome thoughts that come to your mind and to be at peace. Sadly, burden bearing through worry dishonors God. Burden bearing through worry dishonors God. God wants us to demonstrate our trust in God by casting our cares and our burdens on him and experiencing God's faithfulness in caring for us. Well, I've never thought of it this way. When I started to hear the devotion going towards Sabbath and rest, it was a little confusing to me. I thought, oh, aren't we talking about casting our cares? And what does this have to do with rest? And when she began to talk about not carrying burdens, which, you know, I've always thought of Sabbath as like, don't physically carry anything. Like, you shouldn't be lifting anything. I'm always looking at the Sabbath elevators in the hospital that stop at any floor because you're not supposed to be pushing any buttons. But this idea that on Sabbath, we shouldn't be carrying burdens either. Emotional burdens. That was pretty radical thought, or at least very different thought than I'd ever thought before. On Sabbath, are we carrying our burdens? Are we finding time for the rest, not just one day a week, but every day? God does not want us to be burdened. God does not want us to walk in such a way that we are emotionally weighted down. I was speaking with someone recently, and I said, I can see the weight you carry. I can physically see the weight you carry. And all of a sudden, she began to weep because she was in that place where she was, I'm gonna carry these. And when I told her I could see it, all of a sudden, it just kind of melted off of her. Friends, what are the burdens that you are trying to carry? Carry with your own strength. carry because you're too afraid to tell anyone that you're holding on to these? What are the burdens that you're afraid to let go of? Because if you let go of them, you're not so sure what will happen or who you will be without these burdens that have defined you for so long. Friends, God does not want you to carry these burdens. So what would it mean today for you to let them go? What would it mean for you to ask God, God, I need you to take this from me today? Or call up a friend and say, I don't know if you know this, but this is what I've been walking through, and I need someone to listen to my story. I mean, there's many different ways that we can let go, but we don't have to keep carrying these burdens. It is not God's will for your life. So today, what are the burdens you are carrying, and what would it mean to let them go? Let's pray. God, we come today carrying burdens, things that we are worried about and anxious about, fears we have for the future. Lord, we come carrying the burdens, the weights that we have physically taken on. Sometimes it's the care of people in our lives that seems too much. Sometimes the burden is things that we have done or not done, things we have said or left unsaid. Places that we know we should have gone, but we're too afraid. Lord, there are so many things weighing us down, that there are days that it's hard to get up and walk on. And then you remind us that you are faithful. It isn't your desire that we be burdened. You want to give us life and give it abundantly. But we are so weighed down that we can't even seem to get up to experience life. And so today I lift up each person on the call, whatever burden they are laboring under today. Lord, help lift it up. Help them to offer it up to you, to let go, and to trust that you will never let them fall. God, thank you for loving us this much, for the freedom that you offer us, that you offer all your children. Help us to live into that freedom today, to find the rest that you truly want us to have. We ask all of this in your name, Lord Jesus, as together we pray the prayer that you taught your disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Friends, you don't have to keep carrying these burdens any longer. My prayer for you today is that you will find some rest. some chance to let go of those burdens, to lay them down and experience real life. God loves you, my friends. God loves you. And so do I. Have a very blessed day, and I will see you tomorrow in worship at 11 o'clock. Tomorrow, we are finishing up the series on good news, and it's always good news to gather together. So I look forward to seeing you tomorrow in worship. Bye, friends.